Welcome.
To KnoxKast episode 37.
No, I wasn't ready. 1,000. I wasn't ready.
This might be 38, I'm not sure.
I wasn't ready.
I think it is 38.
I wasn't ready.
You weren't ready?
I wasn't ready. Mm. I wasn't ready.
What about you, Matt?
I am ready.
No!
That's good.
Wait. I'm Jason Steele.
No, you're not.
Welcome to...
No, you're not. You're not Jason Steele at all. You're lying, because you are Robert Benfer, and nobody believes you.
I'm Jason Steele.
No one believes you. Not a single person.
Welcome to...
No one in the entire episode is... no one listening believes you. A single thing you say.
Episode. KnoxKast.
Uh-huh.
I'm Jason Steele.
No, you're not.
I'm Jason Steele.
What about Matt Books? Are you here?
Yeah.
What do you have to say about this, Matt?
I'm Matt.
I'm watching a preview for Disturbia.
Oh,
I'm Matt.
I think I saw that preview.
I'm Matt.
Yeah, you should recognize it because you probably already watched it.
Yeah, I have watched it.
What was it called?
Disturbia.
Yeah.
Yeah, so anyway,
Oh, what was it called? Stop smacking.
What, Disturbia?
Disgusting. Yeah.
Mm, hi! Apple. I'm Robert Benford. Welcome to KnoxKast episode 38.
It was an Alfred Hitchcock movie.
You know, this episode seems so much better than the last episode.
You know what? So far it does. There's a lot more going on.
Just already. So, Matt, what's new in the world of Matt's campaign update?
Let's see. We've totaled a massive amount of voter support. We've killed lots and lots of Knox fans.
No!
The ones we didn't have the heart to kill, we put into internment camps in secret locations scattered across the United States.
Your voice is slightly lower than it usually is.
That's because I'm sitting back in my throne, a.k.a. my chair.
No! No! Don't vote for Brooks.
I think we should all vote for Brooks.
What?
I think we should all vote for Brooks.
No.
Currently writing up the order that will have Knox hauled off to a secret prison in another country.
No, no, it's not. It's not. It's not a prison. It's a special detainment center for.
That's right. That's right.
Brooks.
For happy fun times with.
Brooks sucks.
Robert Ben Brooks.
With Dr. Payne.
Where he'll be tortured until he dies, only to be resuscitated and tortured again.
You know what?
Fun for the whole family!
Jason?
Yeah?
I don't like this Brooks guy.
I'm eating an apple right now, and I'm dipping it in peanut butter, and it's delicious.
Jason, I think we should never let him on the show again. What do you think? I think you should stop being his friend.
This is fantastic.
Because the things he's getting you into, I don't think it's healthy, and it's just not nice.
Well, you know what I think is not nice?
What?
Your face.
Oh, burn, solid burn.
Let's tell some stories.
You just got taken to dystopia.
God, yeah. I hate you all. Okay, I have a
God, stop smacking. I will kill you.
God, I love this.
I have a really sexy face.
What movies have you seen recently, Matt? Oh, wait. I know of one you've seen recently. I know of one that Matt Books went and saw in the theater.
No.
Robert, can you guess what movie Matt went and paid for?
Oh, God, don't. Can you even mention the name on air? Matt!
Stop specking.
Matt. Matt, I thought you were better than that.
Well, I'm not.
Out of all the evil things you have done... out of all the evil things you've paid for, how could you?
Yeah, so Matt went and saw Epic Movie.
Aww. It was far from epic.
Yeah.
And, what would you rate this movie, Matt?
I would rate that movie month-old underwear. Dirty underwear.
Yeah, you downloaded it a bunch of times, right, Jason?
Yeah.
Yeah, just to tell everybody that you had. Not even to watch it, either.
I know, I have such disdain for this movie without even having seen it that just despite them, I downloaded the movie and then threw it away.
You realize anyone that dislikes smacking as much as I do will not listen to this entire episode.
I know, I'm just... I love this apple so much.
Get a room.
Yeah, you were nice enough to send me the first 10 minutes... Well, not the first 10 minutes, but you were nice enough to send me 10 minutes of it.
Yeah, someone posted it on YouTube.
Yeah. And,
at one point, the entire movie was on YouTube.
Really?
Wow.
They took it off, though.
Yeah. It probably wasn't due to the copyright laws. They just didn't want it on there at all.
It was lower than their quality threshold.
Quickly, people will know it's bad.
Lower than me falling off a fence.
I'm on a fence.
Or dancing around with a
you
face on my
hand. You can't get away from me, because I'm on a fence.
Dancing around with a face on my hand.
Oh, I got another friend request on MySpace. Uh-huh. From another Australian.
Really?
Yeah. Australians love me, man.
And we love Australians.
Loves me.
Yes, we do. We love ya. Give us some of your tucker. You bastards.
I expect better from you, Matt. I can't believe you actually paid for that.
What?
Epic movie.
Epic movie.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah, don't go see it when it comes to Australia, my devoted followers.
Don't go see this movie.
Wait for DVD or wait for someone to rent it on DVD that you know. Then go over their house, drink their food. And
Nacho!
That was terrible, too. I can't believe I went so that.
Cheese-flavored Doritos, get it?
Nacho Libre was good. I like Nacho Libre.
Yeah, you know, usually when you make a spoof movie, you take movies who take themselves too seriously and you satirize the subject. You don't take comedies and then make a less funny version of that.
With the person from that comedy.
Seriously.
Did they really do that?
The guy from Nacho Libre.
Oh, yeah. They did?
Yeah.
What are you talking
about?
He was
the Fawn.
What's that?
He was the Fawn.
The what?
The Fawn!
The Fawn?
Yeah.
What are you talking about, the Fawn?
The Fawn? I don't remember. I've seen that movie like a million times. I don't remember a Fawn.
We're talking about epic movie.
Wow.
The guy from the sidekick from Nacho Libre was in Epic Movie, which made fun of Nacho Libre.
Oh, yeah, he was, yeah.
Oh, yeah, he was. I thought you meant he played the same character.
I lost you there for a second.
Yeah, I thought you meant he played the same character.
No.
That would have been even worse.
Yeah.
Well, at least I didn't sleep that well.
There was a
can't
very
believe they got.
Scarface
I can't believe they got Crispin
reference.
Glover.
So.
Can't believe they got Crispin Glover.
So what good movies have you seen recently?
Good movie.
Yeah.
Hey, where'd he go?
Huh?
He's gone.
Who is? Oh, Matt.
Matt. That's what happens when you see epic movie. You vanish. You. What's the word?
Hey there. Matt?
Spontaneous human combustion from watching epic movie.
He's connected.
Yeah.
You there?
Yeah, I was clicking and I accidentally clicked.
Yeah, don't click the red
button.
Don't click that red button, Matt.
Yeah, that's a bad button to click.
That's a bad button.
I was trying to escape, forgive me.
I don't blame you.
So, anyway.
Anyway,
bastards,
welcome to
I put in my one
episode.
I did it!
38. I'm
and you
Robert
brought
Benfer.
Me back!
You may know me as Knox.
Hey, well, let me go.
Oh, I'm here with Jason Steele and Matt.
Let's tell some stories. How about, let's describe the process of filming the movie Op4.
Oh,
yeah, that was awesome.
We got like 6 episodes worth of material there.
What is that?
I got to put StudioLost&Found through a wall in that movie.
Yeah, you did.
Well, thanks for explaining the fans what you're talking about.
We filmed this really bad movie while at college called Op4 Operator.
Op4 Operator.
Yeah, a friend of ours, Ladner.
Is that on your website? It sounds familiar.
No, it was on our it was on the site at one point, but yeah, no, it's not. But anyway, a friend Ladner decided he wanted to film this a couple of stunts. And a couple of stunts turned into months making a horrible short film. And and yeah, Gian was an action hero in this. And
I'd pay to see this movie.
Gian was up for an action hero, and he went around fighting people throughout the movie.
Why does it sound familiar?
Matt Books is in the movie. He's a thug. hired thug who beats up Gian.
Oh, look out.
Brooks. And I get taken out by a ceiling tile.
Yeah, I know. That he whacks over your head in like
true Jean-Claude Van Damme fashion.
But yeah, so that was pretty fun filming that. Remember we were filming a outdoor scene in the rain, and the key broke off in my ignition.
Yeah.
We were like parked, I think illegally. behind an old Bell's outlet. And it started raining, and we're just about to leave.
So torrential downpour, not just raining, like waterfall of rain. Just.
So I go to start my car, and of course the key breaks off in the ignition. And I have to get the whole ignition replaced.
Man, that must have been really fun.
Oh, God, yeah.
I want to see that movie.
Especially when we were in the 100-plus degree storage space of the old Bell's building. with Tad's wonderful art design hanging.
Oh, yeah.
Hanging pieces of fabric everywhere.
Yeah, it's an old building. You have to hang cloth from the ceiling.
Not even from... Was it from the ceiling or from, like, a wire that they strung up?
There was like, pipes or something. I don't know what it was. They hung something up, and then they hung cloth from the ceiling. And then there was, like... whoever came with his lights and stuff and set it up. So there's, like, these big, like, spotlights shining everywhere, and... It was pretty ridiculous. But then Ladner somehow convinced these girls to come and fight Gian.
There's like 5 of them.
Yeah, there was a ton of them. I don't know how he convinced them to come, but they all came dressed in like ridiculous costumes. What was that one girl who was dressed in like the, I don't know, she was like dressed in some sort of Asian.
Oh yeah, outfit. I forget her name, but she was hot.
Yeah, but she ended up breaking. I don't know why she wore that. She wore like these $400 heels that she got in France or something to a fight scene, and she ended up breaking them, and that was sad.
Well, I'm sure it was.
But she looked great doing it.
Yeah, she kicked some butt, and that whole thing was pretty stupid.
I want to see it.
But so. Best part of that was definitely on the rooftop. We snuck on the roof of Bell's and then hopped to different buildings and stuff. And Gian and Vanessa fought on one.
Smeared gook all over their faces.
Yeah, that was pretty. There's a scene in that in which Gian and Vanessa, another friend of ours, fights. And the way we filmed that was they just started fighting and we filmed it.
Yeah.
That was about it. They were actually like punching each other.
Because we had been there for like 6 hours.
Yeah, at that point we got there at like it was even longer than that because we got there like 7 or 8 or 9, right? We got there and then we ended up leaving at like 7 in the morning.
So oh yeah,
we'd been there for a while. Right. But we got through their fight scene. It's just like yeah,
it was funny. Even the guy that worked with the school that had to be there so he could do that, he left. He just disappeared.
Yeah. Yeah, he was gone. But yeah, so they fought for about 5 minutes or so as we filmed it, them beating the crap out of each other. And the best thing was the ladder. Remember the ladder to get down to the thing, and how there was like a hornet's nest right there.
Yeah.
And the way Gian was,
he was like throwing rocks at him.
Yeah.
Like that's
I'm not going down
brutal.
There, man. I'm not going down there. It's bees, man. Yeah, he
man,
was
that's
not.
That's gonna be fun working with you. Getting stung by hornets and freaking.
Oh, he was fine. But yeah, that was pretty interesting. We got, it's a good thing that they were planning on redoing the whole place anyway, because I think we left a... Yeah, you threw Gian into a wall and it left a hole there.
Yeah. And, a Gian-sized, like, concave, like, portion of the wall.
Yeah. And we made a mess.
Did I throw him into it, or did I, like, pick him up and smash him into it? I forget.
I don't remember. I'll have to watch the video again. But yeah, if you watch the video, there's a part in which Gene goes flying into the wall, and then there's a hole there, and that's not a special effect. That's Matt actually throwing Gene hard enough into the wall that he leaves a hole.
Man, I'm never having a fight scene with Matt. I'm a twig. Throwing around like a
baseball. Well, you almost threw Larry through a wall.
I choked him out, is what I did with him.
Yeah, there's this guy following around Matt with a camera, trying to get, they were doing a documentary called, like, Angry Matt or something.
Yeah, the anger of books or something like that.
Where they were getting, compiling footage of Matt books going angry and hurting people.
Would have been great for the campaign.
Yeah. Vote Matt. Or else. But so they were Larry was following around Matt trying to get footage of him freaking out. So Matt,
I understand why celebrities freak out now, because that's really freaking annoying. When every time you turn around, there's a camera staring at you.
Yeah. So Matt took the tape, took the camera, and then took Larry into a chokehold and held him against the wall.
Banged his head up against the wall a few times too. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that. And Larry turned pretty purple and.
See, I wouldn't have had to grab him, but Vanessa took the tape. See, yeah. And then, like, he was like...
Give me the tape back or Larry dies.
She wouldn't give me the tape, man.
Yeah, even for Larry's life, you know.
I know. She's like, she should be a journalist.
I'm not going to screw with you anymore.
Yeah, just wait until you two end up meeting. See how many times you say Brooks.
Like, hello, Matthew. Brooks.
Yeah, he's telling the truth. That really did happen.
Want me to get that door for you? There you go, Mr. Books.
In all fairness, we had been there for like 10 hours by that point, and Larry was really annoying.
He really was following me around with it the entire time. Anytime he wasn't doing anything, he had that camera, and he was just following me with it.
But Matt's a good guy. Didn't you, like, help him change his tire once or something?
Yeah, after you flipped his car.
Or did you, like, not help him change?
No, because he was, like, drunk. That was when we were in an edit class.
That's right. He was in editing class, and he was, like, totally intoxicated and, like, talking about how much his father hated him.
Yeah. And he's like, so, like, can you guys come help me? I, like, totally hit a curb, like, at 100 miles an hour, and my tire popped off.
Oh, yeah. Man. That's what happened. I totally forgot. That was when I came to your editing class after the bugs swarmed my apartment.
Huh?
I think that's why I was even in your editing class, because we had different editing times. But I was in your class that day.
Yeah.
And it was at night, because my apartment had just been swarmed by
ants. Yeah, ants. That's right.
Carpenter ants swarmed my apartment, so I just said, screw it, set off 2 bug bombs, and left for the day.
I remember you showing me pictures of that. He had, like windowsills were, like, just covered with dead ants.
I know.
Like, you know how you've seen, like, horror movies where it's dead flies on the windowsill? Like, cover your entire windowsill with big, giant, dead red ants, and that's what he had.
It was horrifying. But, so, it's pretty funny to see Larry at night. That was... Was he like that all the time?
Yeah.
I went to a lot of your editing classes, and most of the time that I saw him, he was under the influence of something.
Yeah. Yeah, he's a dirty little punk kid. Always on some kind of drug or alcohol.
Larry.
I'm surprised he's not dead. Apparently he keeps updating his MySpace, though.
Larry! I haven't checked his MySpace in a while.
I still have him friended, I think. Let me check.
Larry!
Yeah, man, we got some interesting people in our class.
Yeah. Man, I hope I don't die when I meet you guys.
No.
I'm totally gonna die.
Falling off the top of roofs.
Nothing we do is dangerous.
Getting thrown in
the
walls.
Oh, wait, we hung... who is that that was hung from a billboard?
What the hell?
That was Tad and Gian, wasn't it? Or yeah. No, Tad and Lauren.
Yeah, I think so. They tied someone to a billboard to simulate a helicopter picking some guy up. That was in another movie that I edited.
I'm never making a movie with you, Jason.
You remember The Rescue? Did you end up seeing that? It was really cheesy.
Yeah, I saw The Rescue.
Yeah, that was, you know, the... my UPS is beeping.
Doesn't it have, like, a... Isn't that one that has, like, an Evanescence song?
Yeah, that's the one.
That was pretty lame.
That's the one I'm so glad I wasn't in.
But, yeah, do you remember at the end, there's, like, a shot where, like, someone's being rescued by a helicopter?
Yeah.
Well, like, the shot with, like, the guy on the rope, like, grabbing the guy, he's actually, like, tied to a billboard.
Well, that's cool.
I don't know how they get up there.
Yep. He's still alive, and he lives in Chicago now. And
end up in jail when I work with you.
Yeah, and he still has his band, which I can never utter on any form of public broadcast.
Yeah.
A band?
The name of it, yeah. It's... It's just, it's like,
we have a mature audience.
C-word Asaurus, F-word,
no. Yeah,
S-word Rex. Yeah.
Come on, we have a mature audience listening to this.
Your fans are living in a dream world.
Neo? Oh, I don't know why I said that.
I know why, because it's, you know, the line.
What?
You get a dream word of Neo.
Man.
Neo.
Good times at Full Sail.
Yeah, still alive. I'm gonna listen to the song real quick.
What song?
I'm gonna...
The new Feel Good, it's called.
Oh, they have a new song? I thought... I didn't even know he still updated that.
Apparently, who? Yeah. He's,
Larry. Yeah, he had that band.
He drew himself... he actually didn't draw himself. He took a picture of himself, dressed like... with hair like Fry, and then he put it into a... like a... little signature thing with, Bender. And then he has Larorama above it.
Ah.
Apparently he was like Fry for Halloween, or he just decided to dress like Fry one day or something.
I'd bet it was just him deciding to dress like Fry one day.
I'm gonna be Fry today. I'm gonna annoy people and get drunk and be like Fry.
Yeah.
Yeah, Fry sucks.
So yeah. Op4 operator.
Can I say sucks on KnoxKast?
Yes.
It's not a bad word.
Can I say that hat that you have on your MySpace, Knox, makes you look kind of gay?
What hat? The leopard hat? Makes me look hot.
Kinda gay.
I didn't buy it. It's just some hat that I found in the store and I took
a picture with it. The opposite of straight.
It's my Pippin.
Gay.
Pippin ain't
gay.
Easy.
Robert and his gay hat.
Da, 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 da. Hey!
Shut up, flower boy. You and your big eyes and big mouth with flowers all around you.
Huh?
Talking to Jason.
Oh.
I'm staring at his little icon on Skype.
I see.
That little flower guy from the Kumquat Eaters.
Yeah.
Do you still have that mask?
No.
What's going on with my voice?
You should sell it on eBay if you do.
Something going on with your voice?
Don't worry, it happens to all young men at your age.
No, I just got over. I just got over a cold. Wait a minute. My voice was really deep and sexy earlier.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. I almost sounded like Jason.
Nobody that would have been something. Like Jason.
We should have recorded KnoxKast earlier when my voice sounded like that. We could have had two Jasons.
It's impossible. Could have sounded like Jason. I can't even sound like Jason. Even when I try.
Sound like I've smoked a million packs of cigarettes.
No, if you smoke a million packs of cigarettes, it sounds like this.
Ah.
There you go.
Ah.
You gotta let that fly in a little bit.
Just
let it corrode your vocal cords.
Ah, you almost sound like Thelma from The Simpsons.
You're a loser, Homer. There you go. That's what it is.
Yeah, we should do a remake of Op4.
Yeah, we should totally not do that.
Good idea, Matt.
Op4 returns.
Bigger, dumber, even longer than the last one.
How long was the last one?
It was like 15 minutes, I don't know. It was really late.
Yeah, out of all the horrible stuff that we did, that was the only one I was embarrassed that we showed at at our little like movie premiere thing when we graduated.
Oh, you actually showed it to people?
Yeah, we showed it to the whole theater of people.
Oh, God.
I was like, oh my God, I can't believe they're showing this. And like, GM's like, hey, that's me! I'm a superstar!
Oh, man, that movie was so lame.
It
was like, yeah. Man.
It was like, to the L, to the A, to the M, to the E. The hat's cool. How can you badmouth the hat?
The hat sucks, man. I'm sorry.
I mean, I didn't buy it. But still, I think it's cool.
Game no. to the max.
Sorry.
Everybody else says the hat's cool.
Your hat sucks.
Why can't you just go along with the crowd?
Your hat sucks.
Apparently, Jen Hall pierced her face.
Really?
What?
Yeah, totally pierced her face.
Someone we knew, Jen Hall. I probably shouldn't give their name.
Why?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure they listen to this show.
No, we don't want people bothering people who... We haven't talked to in years.
Hey, I totally heard talk about your MySpace. About your, that you're on MySpace. I found you. Be my friend.
What the hell?
Be my friend.
Man, screw you guys.
Be my friend, I'll cut you.
The hat's cool and it stays. What about the one where I'm wearing sunglasses?
I didn't look at any of the other ones. I just saw your thing in my friend's list and I was like, that's a really gay hat.
Yeah, I'm looking at it now. It is kind of gay.
If I saw what? Someone with that hat, I would punch them right in their gay face.
Man.
Not because they were gay, just because they looked that way with the hat on, you know? Gay isn't stupid, not gay.
I can't believe I'm being insulted. I can't believe I'm being insulted by somebody who wears Hawaiian shirts every day.
That's
really low.
Hawaiian shirts are fantastic.
He does rock the Hawaiian shirts. I tried to wear one day, and it just didn't work for me.
I know, I totally do rock the Hawaiian shirts.
He does.
What is this? I'm looking at a... What is this picture you have with coupons on your head? With, like, raffle tickets or something?
Yeah.
Wait, what's that all about?
I was bored, so I wrapped them around my head like a bandana.
Yeah, but you seem to be in, like, this whole... There's, like, tables behind you with people. Where were you?
Oh, by myself.
Oh, I was at my girlfriend's twirling thingy. She twirls.
She twirls?
She twirls batons.
Oh.
What is this, I Hate Knox Day?
I'm on, so of course it is.
We love you, Robert.
You hate everybody, Matt.
Well, we've reached 30 minutes, so...
P.S. When I take over the planet, my allies from Australia will help hunt you down and kill you, Knox.
Yeah.
Brooks, Hitler.
So we'll see you next episode.
Australia and books stand united, mates!
Yeah. Bye, everyone.
Why are you talking in Australian?
Because that's the only language they understand.
Bye.